to you a FAIR Health Information System, which is a case study based on the Virus Outbreak Data Network Africa. And I'm presenting on behalf also of Professor Francesca Oladipo, who is the executive coordinator of Vodan Africa. Myself, I'm the global coordinator, and I'm the shareholder of the chair FAIR Data Science at the Leiden University Medical Center. It's a pleasure here to speak today. And I wanted to start with a brief formulation of the problem. So we saw at the beginning of the pandemic that really data from Africa on COVID-19 were missing. And so we were seeing that as a problem in order to really understand the causes, but also the prevalence, et cetera, how the virus was affecting different places. And so the question is, why? Why was this so? So as we were looking deeper into the information system, a particular problem that we identified is the lack of ownership and the lack of handling of the data within the health facility. So if you look at slides 4 and then slide 5, you see that we have identified that while data is being inputted by data clerks, that data that is produced in the health facility doesn't remain there, and therefore it doesn't have a meaning. The data doesn't have a meaning for quality care within the facilities. So we thought, if data is produced within the health facilities, it first of all should have a clear ownership within that facility, and this is really at the core of the philosophy of the FAIR guidelines, but also actually a requirement on in GDPR, the legal regulation of the European Union, which identifies clearly that data should be curated and owned within the context of the place where it is produced and relating to the data subject. So on the next slide 8, you find the formulation of the research question, which was, how do we use FAIR guidelines to solve the problem of lack of ownership of data within health facilities in an African context? And so we are now currently working in 9 countries and with 85 health facilities across these countries. And slide 10 shows you the key parameters of a FAIR-based architecture that we identified, particularly that data should be findable, interoperable, reusable, but also accessible under very specific sets of permissions, which are controlled by the facility where this data is produced. And that leads to the following architecture: one embeddable editor where data is produced in human and machine readable format and therefore is immediately interoperable, is deposited and curated within the facility where it stays, can be exported to any other system in a specific relation to the purpose of that system, and can also then be used within visualizations on dashboards that allow within the facility clear use of such data, as well also within the community as process data to help in the analytics of the data in more processed format. That allows us in the future to really think of a much more integrated healthcare system at the level of the facilities, but that also, in fact, with different degrees of the data analytics, data processing, could be allowing us to link data in a secure and well-governed way, even across borders. Here on slide 12, you see this as an ambition of the East Africa community to get a more integrated regional healthcare. This can also be done with research data, as long as the vocabularies speak to each other. And that can then lead to an integrated architecture for particular queries, which is shown on slide 14, where, for instance, on a question of prevalence of COVID-19, research data and data from health facilities can now be integrated in the analytics. And so in this way, the use of digital data on health, both from a research origin and a patient treatment origin, can be used for queries. And this can really strengthen the quality of data for analytical purposes. That depends, of course, on the levels of processing of the data, and the more data is processed and de-identified, the less these data is sensitive, and the aggregate data can be very well used as quality input in solutions for AI, where this data is no longer appearing as patient data or as data from a very particular origin and place. So in the last slide, 17, we have set out the advantages of Vodan Africa in comparison here with the District Health Information System, and where we feel that particularly the FAIR guidelines help the Vodan Africa proposition for data to be handled in format where findability, accessibility under clearly defined permissions, interoperability and reusability drive the meaning and efficiencies of data handling in a modern health information system. And then on the next slide, you see the letters of support that we have received. So it shows also that there is a lot of interest in this kind of a solution. And then on slide 18, you see some background links to our work. And with that, I would like to thank you.